Fenugreek is an herb in the same family as soy, and it's been used as medicine and food for thousands of years in Egypt, Turkey, France, Spain, all over India, and was even found in the tomb of King Tut. You have fresh and dried seeds, leaves, twigs, and roots to make the spice, all used as either as a flavoring ingredient or a supplement to deliver a certain benefit. In this case, hair growth. In this video, we will look at how fenugreek may play a role as a DHT blocker, which we know is the number one culprit when it comes to androgenic alopecia, which causes hair balding. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. Now, you may have heard fenugreek having an elaborate display of very useful biological compounds like your flavonoids, which have amazing effects in cell signaling and antioxidant uses, cumarins, which display an amazing way of preventing blood clots, vitamins like your A, B, and Ds, they got your alkaloids, which are at the basis of a ton of medications. But interestingly, what steals the show after doing a quick YouTube search typing in fenugreek, you find a lot of videos actually talking about fenugreek for hair. It seems to be the most popular use for fenugreek, even though it's used as a way to produce more breast milk and also used for cramps. But for hair loss and overall hair health, is there any actual basis to that? And to really investigate that, you have to go deep into the studies to try and find a link. So here's what I found. Three possible roads leading to how fenugreek will help you restore hair and hopefully prevent further hair loss. And keep in mind that much of this may be observational and hypothetical research. And while I'm not claiming that taking fenugreek will 100% work, I'm simply extrapolating with how it might. So let's begin. Starting with how a study back in 2021 looking at a multimodal hair loss treatment strategy called Gashi, which contained over 12 phytoactive ingredients that affect multiple targets in the hair loss cycle, looked at fenugreek's role. And the reason why they chose fenugreek as one of their ingredients was because of how it can counteract the effects of pro-inflammatory cytokines such as IL-6 and TNF-alpha, and thus by doing so, could positively intervene in the anagen to catagen and catagen to telogen stages of the hair cycle, almost simulating the pathway minoxidil takes when, let's say, you're on Rogaine, which I thought was interesting. And doing a little bit more digging, if patients who had a form of alopecia possible had more IL-6, was there a link with that? And it turns out there very might just be, as one study looked at how the levels of IL-6 and other pro-inflammatory markers were also high in alopecia areata. The second way in which fenugreek can help with hair loss is when looking at one of its major constituents, which we've already mentioned, its flavonoids. In the study that was published this year on hair oils and the role of fenugreek, because I guess fenugreek oil has been used for hair balding for quite some time, what they do is actually cause vasodilation in the scalp, which, guess what? It's what minoxidil does as well. Since it's speculated that Rogaine can widen the blood vessels and open potassium channels, allowing more blood and nutrients to the follicle site, I thought it was also interesting that fenugreek could do that too. And lastly, the most fascinating study, which looked at fenugreek's efficacy against hair loss, actually mentioned the role of DHT and how fenugreek interacts in a physiological way to stimulate blood circulation to the hair follicles and how they use their steroid saponins to interact with DHT metabolism. They concluded that treatment with fenugreek containing food supplement results in favorable effects on hair loss that contribute to improvements in hair growth observed in their volunteers, which were 82.9% who had an improvement for their parameter of hair volume and hair thickness, and 74.3% reported an improvement of hair's resistance. And although the exact mechanism is not known, the closest thing I found to it being a DHT blocker, which by the way is how finasteride works by stopping 5-alpha reductase, which regulates the production of DHT. And why DHT gets a bad rap in their hair loss is because as soon as the DHT levels go down in the scalp, the hair follicles can work again to produce hair. Well, fenugreek tries to mimic that as well. Fenugreek contains diosgenin, which is a biologically active steroid sapogenin that can play an estrogenic role, which works as a DHT blocker for restoring hair loss. Click that red subscribe button down below and comment down below also if you use fenugreek. What form do you use? Have you tried anything that has worked for your hair loss? And if you found any results, I would love to hear what they are down below.